Let us now discuss the effect of internal forces on a system of particles. As we have just now studied that the law of conservation of momentum states that in absence of external forces, system momentum will remain constant. Now we can analyze one more situation based on this fact, like if in a system of particles, center of mass of system is at rest. If it is at rest, implies velocity of center of mass is equal to zero. That means acceleration can cause center of mass to move. In this situation, if center of mass of a system is at rest and if no external forces are acting on the system of particles, then center of mass of system will remain at rest. This is a self-explanatory statement that if no external forces are acting, that means center of mass acceleration is zero. That means velocity won't change. That means this will remain constant. Or we can state if initially center of mass was at rest, it will remain at rest. Or the same situation can be written in a different way. Like only internal forces of a system can never cause any motion in center of mass of a system of particle if it is at rest. This is a very important statement you should always keep in mind, because we are going to see many different kind of problems and situations based on this statement. Here, we once again state only internal forces of a system can never cause any motion in center of mass of a system of particle if it is at rest. Or we can say if it is at rest, in absence of external forces, it will always remain at rest, it won't move. Just to analyze the phenomena we have studied, let's analyze a practical situation in which a boy of mass small m is standing on a smooth ground and was holding a string which is connected at the other end with a large block of mass capital M. In this situation, when the boy pulls the string, a tension is developed which is equal and opposite on the two, the boy and the block. So net force acting on the system is zero. Here we can state, here net external force on system is equal to zero. So we can state center of mass will remain at rest, because earlier center of mass was also at rest. So here we can state, say if center of mass is located at this position, so center of mass will not be displaced with respect to ground, because equal and opposite forces are acting, due to which say the boy accelerate with acceleration A1 and the mass accelerate with acceleration A2. So here we can state a small m A1 must be equals to capital M A2, because net acceleration of center of mass will be equal to zero. In this situation, the boy as well as block will be displaced because the ground is smooth and external force is zero. Both will be displaced and simultaneously they will move in such a way that when block will reach boy, in this situation, they are going to meet at the center of mass. So we can write, in this case, in this situation, boy and block both are displaced in such a way that they meet at the location of their center of mass. So, be careful about it. The situation is only analyzing a practical illustration by which we can say if no external force is acting, the center of mass of system will remain at rest. Let's see an example to analyze the concept we have just now studied. It says a monkey holds an umbrella and the system is floating in air at rest due to buoyancy on balloon. If monkey starts climbing the string at a speed u relative to a string, we are required to find the speed with which balloon will move. As we have just now studied that internal forces can never affect the motion of center of mass. In the situation, the center of mass of system is located at this position. So, we can state, as the question is saying, the system is at rest, that means no net external forces acting on it. So, if monkey is going up at a speed u, the balloon will automatically start coming down with a speed v in such a way that center of mass will remain at rest. Because here if we talk about initial momentum of system, here we know it is equal to zero because when monkey was at rest, balloon was also at rest. So, initial momentum of system was zero. And if we talk about final momentum, it must remain zero. But here, if monkey is climbing up at a speed u and a balloon is coming down at a speed v, the string will also come down along with this balloon. And the net speed of monkey will become u minus v. So, in this situation, net momentum of system can be written as small m into u minus v for monkey in upward direction minus for balloon in downward direction will be capital MV, which must be equal to the initial momentum, which is equal to zero. So, from here on simplifying, we can find out the velocity small v that can be given as mu upon m plus small m. That will be the answer to this problem. Here we can state that we have directly and very easily calculate the final speed of balloon if center of mass will remain at rest.